Okay, we have sound, recording, and wait. Nah, color! Alrighty. Situated here. Alrighty. Hoi hoi, internet! My name is Tom, and this show is called Arcade EC, if the title sequence was not enough indication. And this is the show that chronicles my typical workday at the VG Archives, located deep within the digestive system of the Company Operations Industrial Network, which is where I work. Now, what is in this archive is all of the company's assets, and my job here is to archive all of those assets that are in the archive so that, you know, they can be archived. Now, what are the assets exactly? Well, they mostly consist of video games, hence VG archives. V, video, G, game, get it? Well, anyway, exactly what my job entails is that I take a video game, and then I try it out to see if it's good or bad, and largely if it works, and then when I'm done, I go and type up a few comments, you know, see how we can actually use it in the company or something, I don't really know, but, so yeah, this is basically a vlog about video games, a video game review show, as it were. So why would I start a video game review show, despite the fact that there are already hundreds, if not thousands, on the internet already? Well, the answer is money.
You seem expendable.
Okay, Mr. Anonymous, I promise that I will work hard for you and this...
You will be paid $3.50 per hour.
I'm not sure how that's legal, sir. That's...
You waiter. Pay less. Legal tender.
I'm not sure how I'm a waiter. This isn't...
You wait in a cave. Make tip. And meat.
Okay, I guess I'll get to work then.
Make me sandwich!
So as you can tell from that flashback, I do not make a lot of money here. You see, there's been nobody down here to actually tip me. I'm pretty sure I'm the only person that works here, actually. Well, there's the rats, but they're union. Well, anyway, what game shall we be doing today? Well, it kind of varies from day to day how I choose it, but today, how about we try the scripted wheel of randomness? Metal Gear.
Released in June of 1988 for the Nintendo Entertainment System, or NES, or NES, this game was published by Ultra, a subsidiary of Konami that was created to get around licensing issues at the time. In this game, you play as Solid Snake, a covert operative who is on a mission to stop the sugary terrorist Kataffi from unleashing a doomsday weapon codenamed Metal Gear. You need to use stealth as well as a wide array of weapons and equipment to infiltrate the enemy base throughout. This is the very first game in Hideo Kojima's Metal Gear series, which still has sequels being made to this day.
Well, I better head over to the console room to get started. But some of the consoles are actually kind of old, so it may take a few tries to get the cart rolling, so to speak. So while I'm taking a few minutes to do that, please enjoy this pre-taped footage of a Nintendo being turned on, making it look like it worked in one try.
The moment I began play, I received a call from Last Boss. I mean, Big Boss. Sorry. In his infinite wisdom, he opted to wait until I was already deployed before handing me my mission. That mission was to infiltrate Outer Heaven and destroy the Metal Gear. He told me to locate Missing Our Gray Fox for more information. My mission started. On the next screen, I found a guard. English. Kataffi must be from a rogue Asian sect. Ah! Dogs! Kill! Kill! They say they feel asleep, but the soldiers of Outer Heaven are emotionless killing machines. I continued from the beginning and tried again. My second death came even sooner as the dogs avenged their previous incarnations. On my third attempt, I found that enemies reset after leaving the screen. This would prove quite useful throughout the game to avoid detection. I finally made it past the truck guard and came across two more. Progress was slow, but steady. I came to a maze-like area. It wasn't too difficult since the exit was just the bottom path. Little did I know that this was a dreadful foreshadow for later. After 10 deaths or so, I came to 3 trucks and a walled-off area. I radioed Final Boss, Big Boss, for help, but got no answer. After wandering for a few minutes, I discovered something interesting. Solid Snake was also speaking English. Perhaps it was part of his conditioning to blend in with the enemy ranks. Or maybe he's an exchange student. Using my truck entering ability that I knew about the entire time, I found some rations. They replenish health when used on the equipment screen. I explored more trucks to get the lay of the land. I found card 1 and card 4 in the process. I could now enter the first building. Through my explorations, I found the gas mask, landmines, and my first real gun.
Who just leaves an unloaded gun lying around?
I found my first hostage as well. But I found the next room filled with poo gas. Despite using the gas mask, I couldn't open the door on the other side. I believed I had become lost. I searched fruitlessly for a place to go. Although I shouldn't say fruitless since I found the binoculars in a truck I forgot to check. They let me see what's on the next screen. Very useful. I also found a tank. Not so useful. At my wit's end, I consulted the map. It came with the game, so I figured it wouldn't have any bearing on the department's budget. Although I do like to figure these things out for myself, so I only gave it a tertiary glance for what I needed. I found I could use card 4 to enter another part of building 1. I found another hostage, and that I needed the bomb blast suit to traverse the roof. Even so, I was still stuck. So after many, many deaths, I reset the game in frustration. I regained all my equipment in only 10 minutes, but I was still missing our Gray Fox. After 30 minutes of trying and failing to destroy the tank, I relented and consulted the map again. As it turns out, back at the gas-filled chamber, I was supposed to use card 1 on that door. Feeling a little sheepish, I did just that. Things began falling into place after that. I found card 2, the remote missiles, grenade launcher, and a silencer for my gun. I even got a box to put it in. Eventually, I achieved rank 2. This allowed me to hold more ammo and increased my health slightly. Soon after, I received a tip from a hostage on how to find Missing Our Gray Fox. Using the map that I resigned myself to using more often, I learned the location to do the unthinkable.
Surrender! Me!
But the Solid Snake is a crafty one. They took me right to the solitary cells where, after using my mighty snake strength, finally found the missing our Gray Fox. He informed me that the Metal Gear is a mobile nuclear weapons platform capable of traversing any terrain. Kind of like a tank, but with legs. Fox told me to find Dr. Petrovich, the inventor of the Metal Gear, to find a way to destroy it. In the next room, though, my first boss encounter, and I'm caught with my pants down without any equipment! Thankfully, it was in the very next room. An anticlimactic victory, but satisfying in that I was finally making real progress. I picked up card 3, and with it, the bomb blast suit. I could now traverse the roof in building 1. After crossing a couple of rope bridges, I encountered...
Twin Shot!
A duo of machine gun destruction. Surely the good doctor was being held by these fiends. I was having a bit of trouble taking them down. However, completely by accident, I discovered something. If I allowed myself to get hit, I could use my temporary invincibility to get behind the enemy and get into the rooms without defeating them. Unfortunately, Dr. Petrovich was nowhere to be found. I learned from the hostage in the next cell that he was moved to building 2. So I was off to building 2. But first... I don't like loose ends. I checked the map for the location of building 2. The path was easy enough, however... My old nemesis. Huh. Well. Disguising myself in an invisible enemy uniform, I entered the base. The building seemed to be connected to the sewer system as I was greeted by a gutter of water. After squashing the bully tank, I unjammed my antenna that I didn't really know was jammed in the first place. After that, I had a celebrity encounter. Not wanting to harm a beloved movie star and his stunt double, I opted to explore the rest of the floor. That's something. That's great. Nothing. Nothing. The map said I should find the compass and rocket launcher in these rooms. The boss chart says I need the rocket launcher to beat the Arnolds. What was I missing? I was at a complete loss, and so I was forced to fill out the necessary forms to use the company-controlled internet. A friendly fac informed me that I needed to use the frequency I received to contact Jennifer outside of those two rooms in order for the items to appear. They appeared instantly, so I can only assume that Jennifer is a witch. In any case, I was back in business. With my Hollywood idol vanquished, I was finally on my way to rescue the doctor. Outfoxed? Dr. Petrovich is in building 5? If I didn't know any better, I'd say they were artificially lengthening this game. It was here that I found an enemy I could have never predicted.
An impenetrable maze of aggravation.
I had no choice but to leave and search for clues to its solution. Having the card for building 3, I decided to check there. There, I discovered the oxygen tank. Using my noggin, I decided to try it back in the sewers. While dookie diving, I received a mysterious call from Schneider. Well, who is it? How rude. In the next room over... With Coward the Duck defeated, I at last had all 8 key cards. but Dr. Petrovich was still out of my reach. I was left with no choice but to use the internet once more. I quickly learned of the solution and made it to the front door. After some labyrinthing and a boss exterminating, I at long last found Dr. Petrovich. Unfortunately, now his daughter was kidnapped. Ah, for crying out. Consulting the map, I found an underground tunnel to her alleged location. They led me back to Building 4, where I first met Missing R. Grey Fox. But Miss Petrovich was not in her cell. After another round of requisition forms, I learned that I needed to use my mighty snake strength once again to open the solitary cell. With everyone finally rescued and accounted for, it was time to find the Metal Gear. I finally made it to the final room, and the Metal Gear, it's a TSR-80? But nonetheless, the chart said to use plastic explosives, so I did. Apparently, this computer is firewalled. I suddenly had an epiphany. Despite that I already knew how to destroy it, my avatar, Solid Snake, did not. That meant only one thing. Plastic explosives, you don't say. At last! What? Timer? I hate timers. Timers are bad. Who the... Big Boss is the final boss? How did I not see that coming? Not liking to be had, I showed this two-timing traitor what for. And so, with the Metal Gear destroyed and my ex-boss defeated, I entered the elevator and escaped.
Alright, Metal Gear is finally tested and done. What do you say we add some final comments and archive this baby?
Using stealth is a must early on, but once you get a gun, it's not really necessary as most enemies die in one bullet. Take notes. The game theoretically comes with a map, which I was fortunate enough to have, but these days it may be hard to find a physical copy. Try online to find a scanned version of it if you can. The maze sections are ultimately trial and error. I couldn't find anything within the game itself or even the map for a solution. There is no reason to go into the scorpion-filled desert. Hitch rides on trucks instead. It's faster and safer.
Okie dokie, our next step is... punch out, because that sound means it's the end of my shift. So I gotta go and skedaddle, but thanks for stopping by and watching me play a video game from the 80s. See ya!